Fill the house, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord, In the name of Jesus, God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
In the name of
Jesus. Rick was born in 2014. He was diagnosed at the age of 3.
His in the name of Jesus, God. Heal this house, God. In the name of Jesus.
Lift your worship.
Heal this house, God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we need you all today. We need you.
Your name, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Oh God, we're coming for you right now, Lord God, just that you have your holy way in the name of Jesus. Father God, we ask you to move by your power, move by your spirit, move by your anointing on today, oh God. On this revival broadcast on today, oh God. You have your way, Lord God. We surrender ourselves. We surrender ourselves unto you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, step forward and rain down your anointing fire upon each one of us, oh God. Prophetess Bonnie and myself and those who are listening, oh God. Burn away the chaff and burn away the stubble in the name of Jesus. Oh God, take full control of our thought processes. Don't let us think anything unless it's about you, oh God, and your word and your anointing and your power and your grace and your mercy on today, oh God. Use us for your glory and your honor and your praise, oh God. We don't want to be seen. We don't want to be heard, but we want them to hear you and you alone, oh God. Take away anything that's not like you. We come against any non-well wish. We come against any witch, any warlock, any white magic, any voodoo, any hoodoo, any prayers of hindrance, any prayers that will try to stop this broadcast on today. In the name of Jesus, let it be a boomerang effect on them, oh God. Send it back to them, oh God, and let them realize they're touching God's anointed. They're touching God's property in the most shape. In the name of Jesus, God, move. Move, move, Lord God. We need you to move on today in the hearts of men, women, boys, and girls across this nation, across this globe, oh God. In the name of Jesus, send forth your anointing. Anoint these lips of clay, oh God. Anoint your vessels, your handmade vessels. You chose us. We didn't choose ourselves for this great work that you put in our hands to do, oh God. So, God, we commit it back unto you on this day, March 1st, 2021. We surrender back unto you, oh God. We commit our lives totally unto you on this day in the name of Jesus. Let somebody be saved, delivered, and set free, healed in their mind, healed in their bodies, healed in their spirits on today, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, have your way. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In the name of Jesus, we bless you, oh God. We give you glory on today, oh God. All our steps on today, let us do what you want us to do. God, our steps on today, oh God. Word our mouths in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for it right now in the holy, precious, set aside name of Jesus Christ, the anointed one, the Son of the living God. In his name we pray, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. Lord, I somebody get you. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Oh, hallelujah, God. Oh, hallelujah, God. We welcome you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah, God. We welcome, oh, hallelujah, you, Lord God. We welcome your presence, oh, you gotta see. We welcome your anointing. Oh, that's a manacha. We welcome you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, God. We welcome, oh, yeah, chakarada see. Yeah, manasa, yeah. Oh, God, we thank you, God. Lord, we thank you, God, for waking us up. Oh, yes, I gotta see, God. And we praise you, Lord God. Oh, hey, gotta see. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. To spirit of Lord God, oh hallelujah, he is on, oh hallelujah, he's here with us, oh hallelujah, and I bless, oh hallelujah, his holy name, oh hallelujah, yeah, God, let's see, oh hallelujah, there's nothing, oh hallelujah, like the presence of the Lord God, oh hallelujah, Jesus, Jesus, it's like you can just sit and just bask in it, oh hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. But just thank the Lord, God. We're up here quite a time before we even come live. What you got to see? And so, oh, hallelujah. And so when God comes and he touches, he comes in like a flood. You hear me? Oh, hallelujah. And I just bless the Lord. I pray that everyone had a wonderful and a blessed weekend. Oh, hallelujah. That's what I gotta see. However, the presence of the Lord God, he's here. And so I asked that if anyone and if all of you could share this word, could share, oh, hallelujah, this time that we're communing with the Father, if you could share it with others, or check out to see. We are going to be going into prayer also about a quarter till. So about a quarter till, please go and put prayer requests in at that time that we're asking for them. And at this time, we're bringing forth the woman of God. Oh, yes, I got to see. God's anointed vessel. Oh, yes, I got to see. And I don't know if all of you can see. Yes, I got to see. But the woman of God is dressed in her sackcloth on today. Oh, yeah, I got to see. And I had on my other black, clergy. But God says, put on your robe today.
And so I know what it is when God tells me to go put on my robe. And so I know, oh, hallelujah, without a shadow of a doubt, the woman of God, or she's going to be coming forth with a life-changing word. And so let's just pray, God, use your woman of God. Lord God, your servant, your vessel, Lord God. Pastor Davison, God, in the name of Jesus, I pray you remove all spiritual wax, God. Any stones or walls that are up, Lord God, in people's heart, God, to stop them from hearing the word of God. I pray, Lord God, that as each person receives the word, even myself, God, Lord, that afterwards I'm not the same person. And Lord God, that I have a closer relationship with you. So Lord, use her mightily in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah. We praise you, God. Oh, hallelujah. We bless you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Receive what God has for each one of us today. He's going to be pouring out on today as the woman of God gives the word. So have your heart ready to receive what God wants to pour out on you today. Yes, in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Yes, Lord. Thank you, God.
Amen. On yesterday, God gave me one word, impartation.
Amen. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Yes, yes.
Impartation. Amen. You're going to be able to teach on the importance of impartation, because they don't teach on the importance of impartation.
Amen. Oh,
kinds of impartation. Thank you, Holy Ghost. There is a godly impartation, and there is an ungodly impartation. And many times in the churches there, and people that are creeping unawares, they give out an ungodly impartation. They don't have a right spirit when they pray for people. And they impart demons. They impart unclean spirits into people that come up innocently for prayer. But God wants me to talk today about godly impartation.
Amen. Yes.
And I'll be reading from Romans, the first chapter, verse 11. And it reads, this is Paul talking to the Roman church. For I long to see you, that I may impart unto you some spiritual gift, to the end you may be established. And Paul was saying here, I long to see you, so I can come and lay hands on you and impart some spiritual gift unto you so you can be established in the Christian faith.
Amen.
People are not as leaders aren't establishing their members into the Christian faith by the laying on of hands. They impart so much false teaching, so much their rules, their laws. And you don't see much laying on of hands. I know in this pandemic, you know, you don't see much laying on hands. Put on some gloves. Mm-hmm. If you need to lay hands, if God instructs you to lay hands on somebody, put on gloves. But God wants me to talk about impartation.
Oh, my God. Thank you, God.
To impart, to give, convey, or grant. Impartation is the act of giving or granting something. In the Bible, spiritual gifts are imparted. You find that in Romans 1:11, what I just read. Wisdom, is imparted. Proverbs 29:15. The message of the gospel is imparted. 1 Thessalonians 2:8. And material goods are imparted. Ephesians 4:28 and 1 Timothy 6:18. I did some research on my computer because I didn't have much knowledge about impartation meant. So God had me go do some research. I'm sharing this information so you can know what God wants you to know. And he's saying that all these things you can find in the Word of God. If you don't have time to write it down now, go back and listen to the broadcast later. But God says impartation is so important. Yes. He wants to give us good and perfect gifts. Right now we need spiritual gifts like we never have before, because he was whispering to me in while I was getting ready. He said, you're going to need a spiritual impartation to carry you through in the time that is getting ready to happen. Mm-hmm. You're going to need some strengthening. You're going to need some impartation from the Holy Ghost.
Oh, my God.
Impartation, you have to understand anointing, which means to smear or rub with oil, to ceremonially confer divine or holy office upon by smearing or rubbing oil. And the oil represents the Holy Ghost. You know, when we in sanctified church, they put oil on people. They rub oil on the forehead. They make a sign of the cross. They put oil on their ears. They pour oil in their hands. And they rub their hands together so they can smear it on the people.
Amen.
It represents the anointing of the Holy Ghost. The Apostle Paul named the laying on of hands as one of the six basic fundamental doctrines a Christian should understand. This places it in the very foundation of our Christian beliefs. It's part of our foundation.
Amen.
If you never have anybody lay hands on you and impart a spiritual gift, you're not able to withstand the wiles of the devil. Because a strong Christian should go and lay hands upon the young believers.
Jesus.
When a shepherd had sheep in the pasture, he would put oil on his hand and rub the oil into the head. Rub oil in the nostrils so the bugs can get in and burrow in their nostrils. Rub oil into their fleece so they won't be dry, so their skin won't crack. God wants to rub oil on us so we be protected from all spiritual enemies, all spiritual demons that want to enter in our bodies. Sometimes we've been lately rubbing oil on our ears so the enemy can't get in our ears. Rubbing oil on our forehead so we can be anointed by the Holy Ghost. We're imparting God's anointing upon ourselves.
Amen.
Amen. We can't do it, but when he tells us to go rub oil on yourself and lay hands on somebody, he wants to impart part of himself into us.
Amen.
That's how important impartation is.
Mm.
Many places in the modern church ignore this one important foundational truth if they don't deny it altogether. Many churches don't lay hands. Many churches don't anoint with oil. They figure if I give you what the word says, you good. No. If you're anointed as you say you are, you'll be able to impart what God has placed in you to somebody else. The old mother, they would come with you on the altar, tearing for the Holy Ghost. They come and tear it with you. And they try to impart some of what they got on young people.
Amen.
Help them build up themselves on their most holy faith. But we don't want to do that no more. The church doesn't teach it like they used to. They're most concerned about numbers and finances. We're not concerned about the soul of men. But God is.
Teach. Yes, he is.
He wants to protect his flock. He wants to protect his people, his children, his sheep, because he is a good shepherd. Mm-hmm. He's very concerned about his flock. Apostle Paul taught that impartation was very important in the process of becoming established solidly in the Christian faith. If Paul could recognize the importance of impartation, why don't we? We follow his teachings. Why don't people teach what they teach everything else Paul teaches? And Paul taught in Romans 1:11 about he wants to come and impart a spiritual gift into the people in the Roman church. In the Old Testament, anointing was a very purposeful and pronounced event. When Samuel went to anoint David to be a king over Israel to replace Saul, it was a very pronounced event. He saw David's older brothers, and he went to pour the oil on the other brothers. God wouldn't let it pour. When David came in, the oil poured out that vessel upon David because God chose him. Many people are chosen in these last evil days, but who is anointing them? Who is imparting gifts in them? Who is helping them serve the gifts that was placed in them by God Almighty? God wants us to stir up the gift in us that's about to die. God wants to smear part of himself on us. And not only us, not only me and Prophetess Bonnie and Elder Jonetta and all the other elders and apostles and prophets and evangelists, pastors and teachers, but it's young ones that are coming up in the faith.
Teach.
To smear the anointing, to smear the oil of the Holy Ghost upon them. Amen. Not just with our mouth, but with laying hands. That physical touch means so much.
Yes.
There was a song that says, lay your hands on me, Jesus. I don't mind. Lay your hands on me, Jesus. I don't mind. Why can't we let God use our hands to impart the spiritual gifts? The anointing, because it's only the anointing that yokes are destroyed. Many yokes aren't being destroyed. Why? Because people aren't being taught the anointing is necessary. You can have a good, you can teach a good word, but with no anointing, nothing's gonna happen. Lives ain't gonna be changed. People are not gonna be delivered. People ain't gonna want to have the word to be set free.
Amen. Amen. Teach.
My God in heaven.
Teach. They need that anointing. Yes.
The anointing doesn't occur just because of the touch, because the person places his or her hands by the direction of the Holy Ghost with a goal in mind. Not just laying your hand just to be doing something, but there's a goal. There's a purpose for the laying on of hands.
Amen. Yes.
This is an intentional act. God has an intention. And God is intentional for people to get delivered, for people to be anointed by him through his handmade vessels. This is an intentional act where the impartation occurs. It was intentional when Moses laid his hands on Joshua, when Moses was getting ready to go and be buried on the mountain. He said, God said, go lay hands on Joshua. He's your right-hand man. So go impart in Joshua the anointing I place upon you. And when Moses did that, the children of Israel recognized that this was God's chosen vessel. Since Moses was getting ready to go off the scene, God said, Moses said, this is my replacement, which was chosen by God.
Amen, amen.
But how are we going to know who God is choosing in these last evil days? Just because the pastor say they chosen? It has to be a ceremonial event for the people to recognize this is God's chosen vessel. Not just because the deacons elected me in or the people voted me in. There has to be God's chosen vessel.
Yes, yes.
There has to be God's chosen vessel, God's anointed vessel. Not just because they got a title. A title don't mean nothing without the anointing. You can call yourself an apostle, a prophet, a bishop, but if you're not anointed, you are not effective. And the impartation gift is very important. Moses and the elders, when Moses was about to pass out, his father-in-law Jethro said, "You need to get some help." So Moses chose elders. And he laid hands upon the elders so they could be anointed to go and be over the various groups of people that they had to be over. But without the anointing, you can't help nobody, not effectively. Not according to what God says, not according to the Holy Ghost. When Elijah was getting ready to leave, he laid hands on Elisha, who was his replacement. Paul and Timothy. Paul laid hands on his son in the gospel, Timothy, to impart spiritual gifts on him. Prophetess Bonnie is helping Evangelist Deanna. She's laying hands on her in the spirit realm. She's helping me. She's laying hands on me by helping me, praying for me. We never met, but we lay hands on one another. When we raise our hand toward one another, that's the same thing as laying hands on one another. We're imparting spiritual help, spiritual strength to one another. God says impartation is very able. Kingdom. They that gives one another strength.
Gosh, I gotta see. Teach.
Everyone does not receive the same level of impartation. Because we cannot all handle the same level of anointing as somebody else.
Amen. Teach.
And our character must be able to handle the amount of power that we carry. Otherwise, we are dangerous to everybody else around us.
Oh, my God.
If God gave me the same anointing that he gave Prophet's body, I believe I would explode.
You're funny.
The type of anointing he placed on her, I believe I would be no more good. My anointing is different than hers. We have the same calling, but my anointing is different than hers. Same God, different manifestations, different administrations. She's a prophetess. She's a apostle. She's an evangelist. She's a teacher. I'm also, but my anointing is different than hers. God uses us in different manners.
Yes, yes.
God. Impartation is a device by which God uses to transfer mantles of anointing from one person to the other.
You teaching, woman of God. You teach.
And God wants me to tell the saints, seize the opportunity and make use of the anointing that God has placed in the body of Christ, whether you are near or far away. It don't matter where you are. Allow God to use that anointing in you. Allow God to use you to impart the gifts, the spiritual gifts, into somebody else that you're around.
Amen. Amen.
Don't be so quick to say, well, I got a title, I'm anointed. No. Mm-mm. You got to make sure of your anointing. Make sure of your calling. Make sure that God has placed gifts in you.
Amen. Yes.
That God has smeared himself on you. Hey, glory. Hey. Smeared part of himself in your life. Smeared part of himself in your spiritual DNA.
Yes.
Don't just assume. It's like me having a style and nothing in it. But this body ought to have some anointing in it, some anointing oil, some Holy Ghost in it. Make sure you fill with the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
He is very
hallelujah.
He's not an impersonal being. The anointing is not there. The Holy Ghost is the anointing. The Holy Ghost is stirring up the spiritual gifts in the saints in these very last and evil days. The impartation, the spirit out of the oil. When Mary came and anointed Jesus, when she broke out that alabaster box and smeared the oil upon his feet, she was anointing him. He was already anointed, but she was anointing him for his burial. So he could come back to life and give us spiritual gifts. It's good to me. It's good right now to me. Impartation is very important. If it wasn't important, God wouldn't have me teaching on today. He would not have me bring it to the forefront, because they don't teach on impartation anymore. Impart part of yourself. Mother, you impart gifts to your children. You tell them how to bathe themselves. You tell them how to brush their teeth. You teach them. When you put lotion on them, you're putting part of yourself on them. You're smearing the lotion on them, comforting them. The Holy Ghost, he's a comforter. God sends the Holy Ghost to impart upon us, to smear part of himself upon us. My God.
Yes.
how I can get it across. I want to say it like God giving it to me, and I'm trying. I'm waiting on you more, Lord God, because you want your people to know the very importance. If your leader not teaching you how about impartation, look it up.
Yes.
Talk to God. God, how would I know more about this impartation? I'm only giving you a tidbit. I'm giving you an appetizer on how important this impartation is.
Yes.
Let God smear himself on you.
Yes.
It's like when a person out in the sun and have a friend with them, and we used to smear our sweat on the other, you know, to be playing. God wants to smear himself on you. Smear himself on you, or smear himself on your spirit. Smear himself on your head. My God, impartation is so important.
Yes, it is.
It needs to be taught. Because many don't know.
Amen.
To have the oil of God rubbed on you.
Mm.
It comforts you. It increases your faith. It increases your spiritual strength. People are going around getting those shots, thinking it's gonna help them. But you need the Holy Ghost to help you.
Yes, amen. Yes.
People of the Lord in your life, these very last evil days.
Teach.
Let God impart himself in you, and he will take care of you. He will see you through.
Oh,
and you're able to impart more of God into somebody else. Impart God into your neighbor. Impart God into your co-worker. Impart God more of the anointing in your brother and your sister. Even your pastor, even your missionaries. You can lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Why? Because God imparted himself in you, and you can impart more upon somebody else.
Amen.
Amen.
You walking heavy, woman of God. Stay right there. Yes.
Very much needed this teaching. It's old fashioned, old time holiness teaching. Don't hear this no more. Impartation. Impart. To give. To share. Amen.
Yes.
To convey. To grant. To give. We don't give like we ought to. Spiritual gifts. We want to give money. We want to give diamond rings and cars and roses and stuff. But spiritual gifts are more valuable than anything on this earth if we could ever give, because it will take us through in these trying times, in these very last evil days, to comfort somebody, to give somebody reassurance that God is real, that God is a healer, God is a deliverer, God can set you free. That's why the word says, lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. It also says, don't lay hands suddenly on no man. You know, make sure that God is telling you to do this. Don't just lay hands on somebody, just be laying hands on them because when you lay hands on somebody you're not supposed to, you'll transfer something to them and it'll come right back on you.
Jesus, you're
not equipped to receive anything, you're not equipped to give anything. You're gonna go from that person more weak than you was before you got there.
Jesus, my God, you walking heavy, woman. You're teaching.
Use wisdom with this impartation.
Yes.
That's why God is giving, God wants us to use wisdom, not just to impart stuff.
Amen.
But to use wisdom, use knowledge. Let with all that get an understanding. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, yes, Lord.
Use wisdom. Don't just think you can impart anything to somebody.
That's right.
Make sure you're spiritually equipped.
Amen.
This right now is straight for the Lord, because it's not on my paper.
Jesus, my God, awesome.
You gotta use wisdom. And be careful who lays hands on you to try to impart some stuff on you.
Mm.
I want to pray for you, but God anoint you now. You better ask the Holy Ghost, can they lay hands on you?
That's right.
You're going to impart all kinds of crazy thoughts and crazy demons up in you, and you want to have anointing like this. You let Prophet Fufu lay hands on you, and he wasn't a real prophet.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right.
Don't let every mother in the house of God lay hands on you either.
That's right. That's right.
Everybody tear with you ain't supposed to be tearing with you either.
That's right.
And you ain't supposed to be tearing with everybody either.
That's right.
And if you know you're not in the right standing, don't lay hands on nobody. Jesus. If you're sick, don't lay, just because you got the title of evangelist, you don't have to always go up to the altar, because you might be in a weakened state. You might have gone through something during that day and you're in a weakened state. Impartation is a very serious operation.
It is.
Because you can transfer stuff and you can get it transferred on you. Spirits do transfer. Spirits
transfer. Yes, they do.
Wonder why you're gonna go to church one night. You don't have no headache, you don't have no aches and pains in your body. You go home.
Mm-hmm.
Find the Tylenol. I need some Excedrin. Because I got a headache. My body aching.
Go in and picked up some spirits. You really? Go in there and picked up spirits. Yeah.
You wonder why you're throwing up. You healthy before you went to the meeting. And you going home, call 911, because I feel horrible. Impartation is a very, very serious thing. It's a serious business.
Amen.
God means business.
Amen.
Impartation. Because just like you can rub the Holy Ghost on somebody, impart gifts into somebody, they can rub the wrong spirit back on you.
Mm,
and God will not have us ignorant.
That's right.
Right. Good or evil. He wants his people to know the truth.
Yes. Can't touch everybody.
Amen. Oh, amen.
No.
God wants his information to be transferred. God wants his people to know the truth. Because you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Impartation is so very, 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 very important to transfer, to give, to share. I want to share all that God has given me.
Amen.
All God has given me. I want to be able to lay hands on the sick and they recover. I did it before and saw one lady come out. She was laying there. She was almost comatose. Prayed with her. She sat up, and my sister-in-law, I went to a nursing home, my sister-in-law was there. And the lady sat up, and my sister-in-law said, this lady was out for a long time, and laid hands on this lady, prayed for this lady, and she woke up. And she said loud about a couple more weeks, and she passed on. But if I had not laid hands on the sick, she would not have recovered, even for a short while. But I imparted the anointing of the Holy Ghost into her. God wants to equip his people. And it's up to us to teach this great and wonderful gospel. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. Woo! Amen, amen. Oh my God, amen. Oh Jesus, amen. That, oh hallelujah, that was an anointed prophetic word of God. Remember when I came on and we were praising the Lord and I told you that God had given me the word for tomorrow?
Uh-huh.
I'm like, well, Lord, what do I teach now? Because you taught it. And he had another point for me to bring up. But, oh, hallelujah. And so, Jesus, God is awesome. And you were so on point regarding the impartation. And one of the things that I remember that, it can be a gift also, like God is giving me the gift of impartation. And the part that you said, you don't do it unless God directs you to go and do so. And because when God directs you to be used as that instrument or that vessel that he desires for you to impart, that he desires to impart maybe a gift into someone, he's going to give you and direct you exactly what to do, where to touch, if to lay hands, if not to lay hands, or whatever. And that person has to be at a state spiritually to where they are able to go and handle that gift, because God's just not going to impart something into somebody that's not ready to build a wall. Oh, hallelujah. Issue. I got to see into that calling. And so if we do have that gift of impartation, then, and that we are able to impart, you said a mouthful when you said to wait on the Lord and do it when God directs you. And it's so important also when you said that, because we can't have any and everybody touching us. Because the devil is real, and that people will go and impart all kind of crazy stuff up in you. I remember one of the mothers, she said that she had went one time up for prayer. And when she left from there, she was having all kind of issues and everything. And so she says, I'm not going to that person anymore for prayer, because I started having issues that I haven't had in years. And so she had to go and pray that off of her. And so we just can't allow anybody to touch you. And if you're at a church and that they have different people up there, some people call them altar workers, you need to pray and ask God, Lord, who will you have me to go to for prayer? And if he doesn't give you or tell you someone, you don't go. You have to, and that's why it's so important that each person have that individual relationship with God, because you can go somewhere and get totally all messed up, and you can have all kind of demonic spirits on you, and you start battling things that you don't even need to be battling. However, I know that without a shadow of a doubt, woman of God, this is a prophetic word from God. And even as I was in the restroom getting ready, some of the same things that you were talking about, God, he was telling me, it's one thing that he says. He said faith. And that, and he also said that people aren't doing his miracles these days. Oh, she got it as yay. And so I guess that's where he wants me to take off at, because it's like you've done laid all the groundwork. Just said everything. Oh, you check out this thing that God was saying. And I'm like, Lord, God, this is why you see me over here so excited. Oh, you check out this thing. The anointing. You hear me? The anointing is real. God's power and that he gives us in getting the Holy Spirit is so important that we get it and that we receive it, but our hearts and our souls got to be right. They have to be right. Woman of God, I hear God saying that there's people up here now that is watching, that's going to be watching, is that they've been praying for particular spiritual gifts. They've even, some have been praying for the Holy Spirit, yet they have not been able to go and receive the Holy Spirit as to where you know by the speaking of tongues. And so if you can let them know, what kind of things can they do and that they should be doing in order to receive the Holy Spirit? Because that's the start of it all. And then that way, on tomorrow, when faith, then I can come in. But that's what I heard him saying. And it was one other thing. When you were talking about that, because everybody's anointing is different. Because each person have different ministries. You hear me? Just like on Friday, Thursday and Friday, when you started speaking, well, when God was coming through you to speak, it the Holy Spirit reacted differently. And I don't know if people saw that, but I call it angel wings. The Holy Spirit had got in touch with me so much. It was like I'm moving like this because of the Holy Spirit. And the thing that's so awesome about God's Spirit is that I was looking this way and my hand went out this way. Do you know that my bottle of water that I had right here sitting, that I hit it and I could see from the corner of my eye it going up in the air. And I was just saying, well, it'll fall on the floor. I get it after the broadcast. But as I'm here and I'm in the spirit, do you know that this hand under the anointing of God went there and it caught it I'm looking this way, and it potted like this. And I don't know if you go back and look at it, but right here. And so when the woman of God is talking about the Holy Spirit and the impartation, it is real. It is real. And I wanted to go and give that example of how the Spirit will move in you and lead you and guide you. And so I pray. I'm turning everything back over to the woman of God, but I just wanted y'all to know that pray and get it. It's just going to fill you in more about how to go get the Holy Spirit on the things that you need to do. So I yield the line back to you, Pastor Davis. And I'm just excited about that word. Yes.
Amen. If you've been praying for spiritual gifts, or you've been praying for the Holy Ghost, first thing is to make sure you get rid of everything that you know is not like God. Any bad habits, bad attitudes, anything you might be listening to, any friends, anything you're watching, get rid of it. Ask God to clean you up. And if you don't know what it might be, ask God to reveal it to you. If you want a spiritual gifts, He will give it to you. You might even have the spiritual gifts laying dormant inside of you. It's probably already there. But talk to God and ask Him to show you, to reveal to you what spiritual gifts you have. Because gifts and callings come without repentance. You might have been born with the spiritual gift you actually praying for. But to be filled with the Holy Ghost, to be filled with the anointing power of God, you got to seek for the Holy Ghost. You got to tarry for the Holy Ghost. He is a comforter. He is the third person of the Godhead. He is a personality of God. He's a manifest power of God. He's God's hands, spiritual hands here on earth. And he uses us. But you got to tarry for the Holy Ghost. You don't have to be in a church to be filled with the Holy Ghost. I was filled with the Holy Ghost in on the side of my bed. And I got refilled in the pastor's office. He will come when you call him. Once you get cleaned up, where he can come in, and he'll finish the work. But you got to acknowledge you got some habits. You got some things you need to be delivered from. And that's when you get filled with the Holy Ghost. I can't give it to you. Prophet's body can't give him to you. You got to ask for the Holy Ghost for yourself. We can pray that you receive it, but you got to go to God for yourself. He is a gift. I can't receive your gift for you. I had to receive that gift for myself.
Amen. And for the people that may not know what tarry means, can you let them know what, when you say tarry for the Holy Spirit, can you let the people know what you mean by that?
Tarry means you got to spend some deep time in prayer. when you wait in line for some food, it's waiting. You got to wait because in the book of Acts, in St. John, it says, Jesus said, Tarry, told the disciples, tarry at Jerusalem, but wait at Jerusalem. Until you be filled with power from on high. He said, wait, go into Jerusalem and find you up a room, find you some place to tarry, find you some place to wait. When you go to the restaurant you gotta wait on the table. You gotta wait on the Holy Ghost. And he's better than a dinner reservation. He's better than any plate of food you could ever get. You gotta wait for the Holy Ghost. They used to have tarrying service. Tarrying service, they were really, really waiting services, waiting for the endowment of the Holy Ghost and waiting for the infilling of the Holy Ghost, indwelling of the Holy Ghost in your life. And the evidence of being filled with the Holy Ghost is speaking in tongues, other tongues, the unknown tongues. Sometimes you might stutter, or you might jabber, you might, and then God will give you your heavenly language. You might be speaking in Italian and you never learned Italian. You might be speaking in Chinese, Russian, whatever it is. It is a known language that you never learned, because when it came out to the upper room, the disciples that were speaking in other languages, they never learned because they were where? In Galilee. But people from Mesopotamia, people from all other countries that the disciples never was at, they heard them. They heard the disciples, the 120 that came out the upper room, glorifying God in those people's languages. Go read the book of Acts. Acts the second chapter.
Yes.
That's when you know you really feel it's the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
When you can speak in an unknown tongue.
Amen. Amen. And you're so right about understanding, because I remember when a gentleman from Africa had reached out to me, and Prophet Collins, and I was watching him pray for someone online, and what he was doing is that in it he was casting out a demonic spirit out of a woman. And so I says, I watched the recording that you were doing when you were preaching, and you cast the spirit out of that young woman and what you were saying. And he was like, oh, you hear? And he says, I was praying in African. And I was like, but to me it was like he was just talking regular English. And so, you know, and you turn back and you'd be like, my God. And so those are part of the gifts, that are one of the gifts, to where you are able to understand in different languages. And then you also are able to hear and interpret if God speaks, and that an interpreter will come across to be able to speak it. However, if there's not an interpreter at that point, that's when you don't go there or whatnot. However, it is just so important for the Holy Spirit, because that's the beginning. Woman of God, you mentioned the book of Acts, and it is so important. And I thank God that, and two, that was you just listening in the prophetic, because God did also, because he was saying that the book of Acts, it's the only book of the Bible that is not complete.
Amen.
And it's not completed because the acts of the apostles, of the servants, of the evangelists, the prophets, they continue.
Yes.
And so God, he equips us with the Holy Spirit. But the things that the disciples of Christ did in the book of Acts are things that we're supposed to be doing. Mm. So just like the woman of God says, why are there not miracles happening in the church today? And those are things that there should be a sign of. And so, and that's one of the things that this teaching, oh hallelujah, this prophetic teaching, it places us in the mental mindset and spiritual mindset to start utilizing these gifts again that God gave us, because we've gotten so far away from it. And I thank God for your obedience, for bringing and doing this teaching, woman of God, because it is so important. It is. It is so important. And so, Lord God, please replace all virtue, God, that has been pleaded from the woman of God as she has taught this anointed prophetic word about impartation. God, continue to pour back into her and use her mightily. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. I just thank the Lord God. At this time, we are going to start going into prayer. And so if you have a prayer request at this time, please write it down. I haven't seen any so far, but if you have one, please write it down. And I do see, oh, hallelujah, Evangelist Deanna. She's with us. She's been up here watching too. Hey, woman of God, hallelujah, hallelujah. To God be the glory. At this season, God is pouring out more and more and more of his anointing and his gifts on those that are seeking him, truly seeking him, because it is going to be needed in such a time as this. Lord, Jesus. And God is leading me, woman of God, because of the prophetic word that he has given you, that for you to do the prayer, and that I'm going to touch and agree with you on that prayer.
Yes, Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus.
There's some that he's saying that need a deliverance, and some that's going to watch it, that they're going to be needing deliverance. And that's one of the reasons why you're dressed in your sackcloth, and God told me to go put my robe on, because there's some chains that need to be broken. So as you pray, God is going to be breaking some things. He's going to be breaking some things off of people. One person, God is saying that have y'all, I don't know if y'all seen that picture of a person to where they open up their chest and that there's all these other people that are inside. Somebody has that going on inside to where there's other spirits that have been, as a woman of God says, transferred. They've been transferred to you. And some are transferred through sexual relationships, some by people praying, laying hands, and all of that. So go to God now also and just ask God to do that spiritual search on you and to remove any spirits that have been imparted into you that have not been of God. And I'm going to stand, woman of God, because I don't be playing with no spirits or anything. So I'm going to stand as you pray. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord God. Jesus.
Utterly destroy the yokes of the minds of the people, oh God. Loose the shackles off their throats, oh God. Loose the shackles off their mouths, oh God. Loose the shackles off their hands, off their feet, oh God, off their ankles, oh God. In the name of Jesus, go into their chest, go into their spirit, oh God, and drive out all those demons that were transferred into them, oh God. To people laying on their hands and sexual relations, oh God. In the name of Jesus, take my ambo koba shetebo. Do a spiritual surgery on them, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, have your way. Have your man yosha. In the name of Jesus, God, do spiritual surgery. Oh God. Hold on the eyes, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Oh God. Your way, have your way. Deliver, oh God. Deliver. In the name of God, move by your power, move by your spirit. On today, oh God. In the name of you, no flesh being glorified, glorify you. Loose the shackles off the people, oh God. Give somebody mind to surrender themselves unto you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You will finish your work in them, oh God, so you can loose the shackles off their mind, off their hearts, off their souls on today, oh God. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Say the Lord rebuke you off of my woman's mind. Say the Lord rebuke you off of my woman's heart. Say the Lord rebuke you off that man's soul in the name of Jesus.
Jesus, yes.
Let your leave and go, you feel this spirit. You demonic force, in the name of Jesus, take your filthy hands off the preacher's mind.
Yes, God.
The missionary's heart, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah, God,
in the name of Jesus, lift your hands off the son's mind. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
They've been catching in their mind.
Jesus,
Savior, I want to be saved. Save me. I confess my sins and my transgressions. Save me, Jesus. Save me, Lord Jesus. Save me.
Save me.
You died for my sins, and you rose on the third day. I confess in my mouth, and I believe in my heart that you are Lord. I said in your word, I shall be saved. I believe, Lord, I believe, and I thank you for hearing my prayer. Thank you for hearing my call, for loosening the shackles off my life. All those who believe and pray that short prayer, you are saved. Confess it. Confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, and he's sitting on the right-hand side of the Father, and you shall be saved. Romans 10, verses 9 and 10. If thou shalt confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thy heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. And with the heart, man believes unto righteousness, you shall be saved. You shall be saved. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hodiah Shabbatasi. Woman of God, when you were seeing the prayer and you mentioned something regarding witchcraft, God was telling me, Hodiah Shabbatasi, I don't know if the person's on the line now, but that's what I was feeling, that the person is watching now. Hodiah Shabbatasi. However he says, what y'all gotta see, there were prayers, our prayers that have went up against you, because y'all gotta see, because of the spirit of jealousy, and envy, they're praying the things that they desire for you, because y'all gotta see, not what God is saying, preparatory type prayers, and then there's someone up here also that is watching. I don't know if they're going to be more that's going to watch, but God says, he gave specific instructions, do not continue, and this is a warning, do not continue to pray prayers against someone else who's not succeeding. God says some has already boomeranged back. But he says, the more you do, there's a triple fold blessing. There's going to be a triple fold anointing like a boomerang back on you. He says, if you do not understand something, that for you just to say, Lord, let thy will be done. Because that is a witch. Desert is witchcraft. And be cautious, because familiar spirits, they're familiar demons, will try to act also, saying, well, the Lord told me to tell you this, the Lord told me to tell you that, he says that pray for the spirit of discernment. Because, when you do, you're going to be given revelation by God. He may have already told you, or it may be a confirmation that when a person says it, But so many people in today, they want to pay the prophet money. There's a $500 line, a $1,000 line, even up to a $2,000 and $3,000 line to go. And for the prophet, you put the check or the money in the prophet's hand, and that the prophet's supposed to tell you what God is saying. That's a familiar demon. That's a witch. Because God's word does not cost. He says that what we're doing here, even when Prophetess Janetta and the evangelist Deanna joins us, he says a prophetic ministry, last day prophetic ministry, because so many have been torn away and God is reaching out. And he wants to equip more. And that is why, he gave the woman of God, impartation to preach and to teach today. She laid out the steps, to receive the steps, but pray. In your secret closet, come before the Lord God, and if it was you that was praying against other people, or if you are going to watch this and you've been praying against other people, go into the Lord God and repent. Repent and ask for mercy. Because in the time that we're in and what's getting ready to come up, you're going to need the Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Hey,
Healing for your soul. It is here. It is here. Repent. And receive your healing. Receive your deliverance. Cry out loud, in your repentance, and God says, don't go back.
Don't go back.
In the name of Jesus, woman of God, you to know that He's going to continue they have no church. He's told you what to do. He says He's going to be with you. He is with you. Some that have been broken, but they come here and they get the word and they get their deliverance. And so God is going to guide you. He says, He's going to lay out the path for you, and to go forth, for you know, He has already ordained. Do not worry about it. He's going to open up doors to help even more to make it manifest. Some don't like your boldness, but the Lord says He loves it, because that is what is needed. And for each time they come against, God is going to bless you and take you higher and higher. God keeps saying this. He said this last week. So whoever it is, stop. Not just on her, but anyone, not just on me or even the prophetess or the evangelist, but anyone, stop. I just keep hearing stop. And at this time, I turn it back over to you, woman of God.
I just heard the Lord say that the main one who's been coming against me gonna have to give.
You're gonna have to what?
They're gonna have to give. They're gonna have to be a blessing unto me. I'm not asking for it. No. I ain't know. Well, this is God.
Yes. Oh,
because the Bible says He's gonna even make my enemies be at peace with me.
Amen.
Oh,
And he says, yes, or shagadasi. They are going to sow the shagadasi. And they're going to say, what else is it that I can do to help? And that person that you still have that, like, in the 30s, that it was like that iron casting that you would have on your feet on prisoners. I've seen this on somebody's foot before, and I still see it. And so that means that you're still bound and still chained, and that's like a heavy weight. It's like you can't even lift up your feet. Oh, yes, I gotta see. And you feel weighed down, or I gotta see. Hold on, my nasha, you gotta see. God says, whatever you try to do, you feel as though you're a failure at it. I gotta see. He says that you feel unloved by your family. You'd be saying sometimes, what else? What else can happen? My things, they throw all my things away. God says, that they are there as a hope. And let them help. And you are, to do the things that you know that you need to. It is a spirit. It is a demonic spirit that is there that got you bound. And it has your mind thinking that the condition and the way that you got things is okay to be that way. God says it's not. Hodiash, I gotta see. And he keeps warning you on these things. No matter whose prayer line you call, no matter what church you go to, you keep hearing this same word and the same thing come across. But still, you haven't changed. Hold on, my nana sahi. God is saying, wonder if, his son, wonder if Jesus came back today. Do you think you would make it into heaven? He says, not so, because you've been told over and over and over and over and over again, and over and over and over, but still, you have not made a change. You're looking at other people instead of you. God says, please look at you, but you got to see. And this is another call out. Hold your shagada to see. He says, take it seriously. Han ma ma na ye. Hold your shagada to see. Basha ma na ye gada to see. I see. Jesus. Ora ka ma na 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 sa asha ye. I saw a coffin that's there. I rebuke death. And I pray in the name of Jesus that you will do right. In Jesus' name, amen. Jesus. And I yield to you, woman of God.
Amen. As I said, the person, whoever it is coming against me, and you're going to have to give you out the soul. Don't get it twisted. We're not up here for money. We're not asking anybody for anything. This is straight God. I don't know how he wants it done. Whatever you give, we're not asking for it. Whatever you give it, give it. I don't want to be said that we're not asking for money. No, that's not it.
That was what was said. God said that they were going to plant in the ministry because God is telling us to do this for no charge.
Amen.
There's no charge because he says it's free.
I wanted to head that demon off before he got started.
Amen.
I pray to God that y'all would I said everything that you wanted me to say. And I thank you. Thank you, Holy Ghost, for having your way on today. You showed up again and you showed out again. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For, as you took Prophet's body, restore her virtue, God. Everything she gave out, everything you gave her to say, Thank you, Lord. Encourage me and strengthen me, oh God. Thank you, Father. Oh God, we bless you, oh God. We ask your blessing upon all those who listen, all those who heard, all those who are going to hear and see, oh God, and feel your presence in the name of Jesus. Let somebody continue to be saved and set free and loose from the hands of the enemy in the name of Jesus. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, to the only wise God, be dominion and power both now and forevermore, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. To God be all the glory. To God be all the glory.